All right, folks, this is live roller derby. This is actually happening. We've got Jacksonville in white and Detroit in black. Our lead jammer to start off this first jam of the first bout of the Have a Nice Day tournament here in beautiful South St. Paul, Minnesota, is Lil Lass Kicker for Jacksonville. And she calls off the jam 1-0 in favor of Jacksonville. I'm Reverend Killjoy. I'm announcing this thing. I'm mostly saying this for people who may be watching at home. I understand this is streaming live, or we probably wouldn't be announcing this bout at all.
So we're just winging it here a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here at the Doug Woog Arena.
The Doug Woog.
The Doug Woog. Next on the line for Detroit, we have Greco versus, Relic. That's Relic for Jacksonville Roller Derby. And Detroit takes this lead jam, second of the game. Here a penalty back block being called.
The star has been passed by Jacksonville to Lucinda Nickers, number 50.
Jacksonville still in their initial pass with the pivot, having the star in their hand.
4 points scored on that first pass by Detroit, and another scoring pass engaged at this time.
Greco pushed to the inside, made to go back to re-enter the pack legally. Jacksonville loses one skater to the box on their blocker squad.
So a big early jam here for Greco of Detroit.
Beautiful hit to the inside by Jacksonville blocker number 17, Pearl. But Greco gets out of the pack, scores 4 points. Jacksonville's jammer remains in the pack, looking to get past number 14, and just a bit of a hit to the outside takes her back.
Well, this has been an extremely long jam and a very lucrative jam if you're cheering for Detroit here tonight in the black jerseys. As they've opened up a lead here on Jacksonville in this one. So Jacksonville did score 4 points in that jam, bring their total to 5. Detroit scored 19 in the second jam of this bout. Real quickly, rip through some rosters here. This is Jacksonville Roller Derby's River City Rat Pack, number 026, Encyclopedia, number 123, Punny Badger, 141, Plea, 17, Pearl, number 2, Low Blow, 22, Lolo Beach is a captain, 2392 Sedusa, 330 Buckeye Brawler, 39 V Furious, 50 Lucinda Nickers, 6116 Spankin' Pickle, 614 Harshmallow, 713 Luna Shovegood, 777 Lil Last Kicker, and 8625 Relic.
For the Detroit Roller Derby, their Derby All-Stars B team, number 07 Rose, number 13 Net Attack, number 14 Oi, number 1530, Eye Catcher. Number 17, Monster. Number 22, Storm Crasher as the captain. Number 25, Sugar Snaps. Number 31, Rider. Number 4, Merle Slaughterbarrel. Number 428, Freakin' Reekin. Number 44, Driver. Number 55, Greco. 667, Luna Rosehip. 81, Slamazon. And number 9, Tessa Hurtu.
Meanwhile, on this third jam, Jacksonville does have the lead. That lead jammer is Sedusa for Jacksonville. 4 points on the scoreboard at this time for Jacksonville in this one.
Both players have lost a block or two to the penalty box. Jacksonville, their pivot, and for Detroit, one of their blockers. Both jammers currently in the pack.
Jamming for Detroit, Luna Rosehip was all the way to the front of the pack, just about past the last person, then was forced to recycle all the way back. So now we've got another 4 points for Jacksonville, courtesy of Sedusa, finally managed to break through that wall of black jerseys. And this jam is finally over. Two more points for Jacksonville on that third pass, bringing their total to 15. Detroit still at 19.
Jamming this jam for Detroit, number 17 Monster. And did you see who the Jacksonville jammer was?
Looks like it's Spankin' Pickle.
All right, Spankin' Pickle. That's a fun name. Looks like Detroit does get that cut called.
So a track cut on Jacksonville's jammer. Going to make this a power jam for Detroit and Monster.
Detroit does get lead. Lots of good work getting out of the front of the pack.
Took 46 seconds to get lead in this jam.
Quite an effective bit of a kill there, keeping that jammer from exiting the pack. And our Detroit jammer is out again. Once more, that's number 17 Monster on a monster jam as lead in control. Last Jacksonville blocker has to let that jammer go as Detroit took control of the pack in the back, capturing a couple Jacksonville blockers.
So thus far, this is the fourth jam of this bout. The teams have traded off lead, but Jacksonville only got 1 point in that first jam. Detroit had 19 in the second one. Jacksonville then got 14 in the third, and Monsters still racking up points here in this fourth jam for Detroit.
Couple big jams early on for these jammers.
Absolutely. Looks like Jacksonville does have a jammer back on the track. It's Pearl now, so I believe the star was passed.
Indeed.
But the jam is called before Pearl can hit the pack. Three more points on that final pass for Detroit makes that an 11-point jam, 30-15 in favor of Detroit at this time.
These two teams still keeping the score very close, again trading off a couple huge jams. And hopefully this jammer will be no less of an exception in terms of excitement. Really nice work at the back of the pack by Jacksonville. Jammer must re-enter legally. That's number 013 for Detroit. That's Nat Attack. And jamming for Jacksonville is number 777 Little Lass Kicker. Don't forget that L, otherwise it might not be such a family-friendly name.
Yeah, I mean, I think it'd be just a different name at that point.
That's true, very true.
Detroit doing a great job controlling Lass Kicker at the back of the pack there. We do have 4 points scored by Detroit's jammer, Nat Attack.
Nat Attack is your lead jammer, is in control of the situation. Beautiful apex jump on the inside.
She definitely made that one look easy.
Absolutely.
It helps when nobody notices that you're skating by.
Jammers are not only agile and strong, they are also sneaky.
And observant. You gotta see what's happening.
Mm-hmm. Yep. In roller derby, you have to keep your head on a swivel, as they say.
They do say that.
Wits about you.
It's a good thing to say so you don't get hurt.
Absolutely.
Looks like V Furious to the line for Jacksonville, facing off against Greco. Greco had a big jam her last time out there. 42-19, the listed score, yes.
Oh, I'm sorry, that was that 19-point jam that Greco scored?
Yes, it was.
Yeah. Greco right now is at the top of the pack, contending for lead position. But of course, V Furious is being quite furiously, I don't have the words. She's just bouncing all around and moving so quickly. It is Detroit that gets out as lead first, though.
Yes. So Greco does have lead. V Furious also on to her first scoring pass. And now we've got, I believe that's a high block call on Greco. So now the power jam to Jacksonville. And this jam will go the full 2 minutes, as we say.
Indeed, we do say that. We'll round out to its natural conclusion. Right now, Jacksonville's jammer is the only jammer on the track.
Well, given the blocking she's faced so far, we'll see how excited V Furious is to go 2 minutes in this particular jam.
Detroit putting up a very strong defensive front. Jacksonville, though, looking to put on the pressure with some offense. That is Greco back in from the penalty box. Again, quite sneaky, but Jacksonville was ready for that jammer to re-enter. Greco is out, and one of the Jacksonville blockers gets an out-of-play block.
Greco's teammates celebrate her nice inside-out move to get four more points on that last pass. And we're just going to have to check the scoreboard and see how many points were scored because both jammers were scoring. Looks like 50-21 is the currently listed score on the scoreboard. 17 and a half minutes left in this first half.
And with one blocker down for Jacksonville, I suppose it wasn't as much of a surprise that on that last jam, Detroit was more successful ultimately.
Looks like Jacksonville's called a timeout.
What do you think they're going to be talking about?
I think the first thing that came to mind is cookie recipes, but I don't think that's what they're going to be talking about. I think they're going to be talking about how
muffin recipes.
I'm not going to coach from the mic or anything, but I think they're going to be talking about how to be more successful at scoring more points than their opponents in the upcoming jam and jams.
I think you're probably correct on that point. More than likely, they are going to be interested in how to be more successful in scoring more points against their opponent.
Yeah. I mean, I have some ideas of what I would be talking to them about, but I also am very clear that I have never been a coach of any roller derby team at any level, and I have no desire to become one.
And why would that be?
Because there's so much less accountability at what I say as an announcer than there is when I'm a coach. That's why.
That's completely fair. That is completely justified.
That's really what it is.
Yeah.
But it looks like Jacksonville's back. They've got their heads on right. They're looking to cut into this early Detroit lead.
We still have more than half of the first period left to go. Like you said, just under 17 and a half minutes. Timeout should be concluding in just about 4 seconds.
Looks like Sedusa to the line for Jacksonville facing off against Luna Rosehip of Detroit. Rosehip is up front, spun around, has to recycle back. Saw her do that in her previous jam as well. This time, the pack was a little disjointed for a moment there. It does allow Luna to make it through lead jammer for the Detroit Derby Girls All-Stars B Team. I'm not going to say that whole thing a lot of times.
Yeah, Luna Rosehip does do a really nice job of weaving through the blockers if in those moments when they get a little bit apart from one another.
4 points on that first pass for Detroit. Looks like Sedusa also on a scoring pass for Jacksonville, but runs into a hard wall of black jerseys at the back of the pack, and now forced to recycle as Luna re-engages the pack again. So Detroit could have called this one off when the opponent had a chance to score, but instead they decided to trust their blockers and think that their momentum will continue, even though it's only continued every other jam thus far.
Yeah.
So.
Again, Luna Rosehip doing, being very observant of those moments when Jacksonville defense is not quite together. However, I did see in the front of the pack and then at the back of the pack, Jacksonville was coming together, recycling. So very nice job by both sets of teams.
That's right. So 62-25, the current listed score. We've got Relic to the line for Jacksonville and Monster back to the line for Detroit. Monster thought she saw an inside line, but it didn't go her way thanks to Encyclopedia, or Psycho as she's known for Jacksonville. We've got a track cut now by the Jacksonville jammer. Thought she had gotten free of the pack, but not to be. So now a power jam situation for Detroit.
Jacksonville, of course, very interested in killing that penalty as best as they can, keeping that jammer from exiting the pack and going into a scoring position.
Very impressive blocking from Jacksonville right now. And they're doing a good job recycling as well, constantly reforming two and three walls up front.
Lateral movement of these defensive formations has been just absolutely stunning.
That's right. Monster has a "are you kidding me" look on her face right now. And she is lead jammer, so that only took a minute and 12 seconds to get lead. Oof.
Only, you say?
I was being sarcastic.
Just only. That was a tough, tough first pass.
But Monster's perseverance pays off as she does get 4 points, relatively easy pass after those first 72 seconds. Mm-hmm. Jacksonville star has been passed to Spankin' Pickle, holding the jammer star in her hand.
And both Jacksonville and Detroit do have a blocker each in the box. However, Jacksonville will be gaining that player back sooner than Detroit will as the jam concludes.
I got tired just watching that jam.
Yeah, especially that very first pass.
Right.
That looked exhausting.
That first pass lasted forever.
But again, perseverance does pay off here. That was 12 points for Detroit to Jacksonville 0 on that last jam.
Yeah, impressive. Impressive.
So they lengthen their lead. The score now 74-25 with just about 13 minutes left in the first period.
Lil Lass kicker. I feel like Lass is maybe the way we would shorten that.
Lass.
I don't know. I didn't get an official word. Is out there for Jacksonville, but it's going to be her opponent at the jam line, Nat Attack, as lead jammer in this one. A huge pileup there on the back straightaway allows Nat to slide through relatively unscathed.
Still sounds like a lot of work. Communicating with her teammates, yelling to help them open up a hole for her to move through.
So 4 points scored by each jammer on the previous pass.
Yep, the last kicker does get out on a scoring pass. Does she get any points? Jam ref is shaking his head. 0 points for the last kicker after those initial four. 11 scored by Detroit on that last jam. They pull ahead yet further, extend their lead 85 to 29.
It's not flashy, but Detroit's been very effective in a lot of these jams. Even the, like you said, even that one that it took 72 seconds to get lead, they still managed to score, was it 12 points?
11, 12, yeah.
Yeah.
So again, successful with scoring the points they do. Jacksonville does take lead jammer, has control then, in theory, of this jam. And that's Spank and Pickle that had the pivot stripe the last time, now starts as the jammer for this jam and gains lead.
Looks like Detroit also has a jammer approaching the pack.
That's Greco.
The call off.
That's Greco.
That's right. It was
We've
Greco.
We've seen Greco jam before.
We have. So 2 points to zero in favor of Jacksonville on that jam.
Jacksonville jammer makes a smart move calling off that jam before Detroit could score a single point with control of lead jammer status.
Looks like that's an official review by
Ooh,
Jacksonville.
That's exciting.
It is exciting. I will not speculate on what they might be discussing over there. I did have a very pleasant conversation with the Jacksonville's coach before this bout. Of course, I can't remember his name, and it's probably written down, but not on our sheet.
Yeah.
So we can look that up and let you know. But
we could reference that, yes.
He was very friendly and informative.
Everyone basically involved with roller derby is generally an okay human being, if not an exceptional human being. So I'm not at all surprised that they
you
were
know,
friendly.
You run into that from time to time.
Yeah.
Yep, so our coaches that's for Jacksonville. We got Icky, Mad Dog Murph, Harshfellow, Misty Montgomery are the four listed coaches. And for Detroit, we've got Sarah Heipel, Rob Prater, Danny Dandachi, and Kelly Genie.
I'm not sure on the pronunciation of that.
Those sound like legal names to me.
I know. What is this? Legal government names with government-issued IDs.
Well, you heard me complaining earlier, Shug, about how people have legal names and they have official derby names, and then they have their derby nicknames, the short version of that.
Deciphering
which of those is what is a really fun game for me since I moved here to join the Minnesota Roller Girls last year.
And we couldn't be happier to have you back.
Aw, I'm very pleased to be here. So the official review continues as our referee crew makes sure to dot all the I's and cross the T's and keep everything safe and legal on the track.
Making the correct decisions when these sorts of discrepancies come up.
Yeah. We got a good crew here. I understand the head referee is No Ship Sherlock, joined by a number of the referees that Shug and I have seen a whole lot of in the Minnesota Roller Girls home season.
Ref crew is second to none. We are so excited that all of our volunteers, including our EMTs, all of the volunteers today, our officials, help make roller derby happen.
That's not right.
Be more excited.
That's right. And you sound so excited.
I'm this is my calm, excited face.
Your excited voice.
Otherwise, I'd be screeching into this microphone.
Yeah.
And the acoustics would just blow the roof off this place.
Fair.
Yeah.
Fair.
Yeah, I mean, really, excited me is a little over the top. So I'm trying to keep it cool.
It's a lot. It's
trying to keep it cool.
Yeah. The ceiling is only so high here at the Doug Woog Arena.
My point exactly, yes. Jacksonville coach has some notes for his players. Following, we are getting word on the official review, what was being officially reviewed.
Ah, so one of our favorite referees, Spike, just gave us the detail that Jacksonville was challenging the lack of a destruction of the pack call, and they're going to get their way. So the no call is overturned to a call, we believe, and that should mean that Jacksonville keeps their official review, assuming that I've gotten good information from Spike. But no reason not to trust
Spike.
Him. Yeah, I do. I mean, I've known Spike for like a decade.
Right?
For heaven's sake.
Spike has been officiating roller derby for a long time.
Jacksonville, after their successful challenge of the official review, gets lead jam. So turning over a new leaf here. That is Sedusa.
And Detroit is at a blocker deficit at the moment, but Greco still spins around those Jacksonville blockers, readying for another scoring pass.
Seems like the jammers are having a pirouetting contest right now.
Lots of spinning. It's gorgeous. Footwork is just stunning.
Points are being scored.
And jam is called off.
Well, the Furious to the line for Jacksonville, lining up there with Monster of Detroit. And it looks like Monster snuck through on the inside lead jammer for Detroit, trying to quell that Jacksonville bit of momentum that they had coming out of that successful challenge. But 93-42 is the score, still in favor of Detroit. And it looks like that lead is expanded, at least in this first pass, as Monster's got those 4 points. Now Jacksonville also on a scoring pass with V Furious.
Monster following up with what looks to be a monster jam, but Jacksonville not to be outdone, fighting for every point, tooth and nail.
I think ultimately I prefer the tooth to the nail. Truth be told, does get through and get those 4 points as Monster manages to make it by, stay in bounds and call off that jam. Just in the nick of time, no points scored there by Jacksonville, and the jammer, or somebody on Jacksonville, would like to disagree with that call. Now we've got a timeout by Detroit.
Detroit does pass the century mark, so they look to be situated in a good place. But again, this is roller derby. The tables could turn at any moment, really. Any huge jam, and again, that lead could diminish. It's possible. They really do have to stay on their game. These are two very tough teams brought to the beautiful Have a Nice Day tournament.
Yeah. The Have a Nice Day tournament. Now, why is it called Have a Nice Day, Shug? Enlighten us.
I believe it would be that the Minnesota Roller Girls B team is called the Minnesota Nice.
Ah.
Aha, indeed.
The Minnesota Nice.
So since this is our B team tournament that we're hosting, in fact, it would be Have a Nice Day.
That's right. Well,
if it were our charter team, or I'm sorry, if it were the Minnesota Roller Girls charter team playing, it would be something to the effect of Have a Mean Day.
Yeah, I think you're probably right.
Yeah.
I think you're probably right. Although we should never forget that the phrase Minnesota Nice, in common parlance, technically does mean to be passive-aggressive. So probably more aggressive-aggressive on the track is the obvious joke to make. Meanwhile, the action has commenced yet again, and now we've got an immediate track cut on Jacksonville. Looked like that jammer, Lass, was well on her way to lead, but nope, the track cut, and so a power jam for Detroit, whose jammer is forced to recycle. That's Nat Attack.
And that is low blow from Jacksonville that ran that jammer back, increasing the distance that she has to cover in pursuit of being lead jammer.
The pack is spreading out, and eventually they've got to let her go. So we do have a lead jammer. Took about 40 seconds to get lead. So enough time to kill the penalty on Jacksonville's jammer. who immediately gets in. The pack was right in front of her, so she snuck in right behind them.
With an apex jump, no less.
Ooh, very impressive. The jam is called before she can score, so 4 points to zero on that jam in favor of Detroit.
Score is now 46, Jacksonville, 109, Detroit. Just over 7 minutes left in the first period. Jacksonville blockers exchanging some notes with their jammer. And on the line for jammering, for Jacksonville is Relic. For Detroit, that would be number 55, Greco.
Well, Greco is the jammer that originally built this Detroit lead, or the beginning of this Detroit lead, although this time forced to recycle yet again. Come
number
all the way.
Sorry, number 614, Harshmallow, driving that jammer to the back. Bit of a pileup. Low block may be assessed. It looks like a Jacksonville blocker is sent to the box for what I assume was a low block.
So Relic for Jacksonville is your lead jammer, but the Detroit blocking wall is formidable as it has been all evening. And the jam is called at the behest of her coach, so 2 points to zero. That's a hard-fought 2 points for Jacksonville.
Just about a minute jam. Have to make a decision sometimes, even when you would like things to go more your way. You just have to call off the jam to minimize the other team's damage on that scoreboard. Jacksonville starting out at a blocker disadvantage with two blockers beginning the jam in the box. Looks like Detroit has a full complement of blockers. Detroit just barely gets lead jammer status. Jammers are very, very close together.
That was fun. So Detroit's jammer did get lead, Luna, but Sedusa for Jacksonville was out in front of her. Now, Luna trusted that that blocker advantage would pay off and allow her to get more points than her opponent, and it did pay off with a quicker first scoring pass. Luna hits the track and calls that one off, so should be an 8-4 jam in favor of Detroit if my eyes don't deceive me.
Thine eyes don't deceive you. You are correct, sir.
Ah! The appropriate announcer cliche is to say, right you are.
Right you are, indeed.
And, you have to say the person's name. So it's right you are, Shug.
Oh, right you are, Reverend Giljoy.
Exactly, thank you. That's
got
courtesy
it, thank
of
you.
Famous and beloved Derby announcer Kent the Politician.
Ah, yes.
If Kent says right you are to you, then you know you've
announcing?
Made it. Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, okay.
He's also serving, you know, in the Ohio State House of Representatives.
You're kidding.
And he has been doing that forever, and he has the best swag of any representative in the entire great state of Ohio.
Holy cows.
He's got like candy bars with his name on it. I've got like pens. I've got a whole like Kent swag section at my house. It's not a shrine.
Not a shrine?
Meanwhile, this is an official review. That's why we're talking about nonsense that isn't even here. things that don't matter, because we don't know what the official review is about just yet, but the referees are coming together to make sure that they know.
Also a good time for some track maintenance.
Yes. Hi.
Hi, Switch.
Switch maintaining the track. Is there anything Switch can't do? Haven't found it yet.
Yep, no. Of many talents, that is Switch. Yep, more track maintenance while the Zebras, is that okay as an announcer thing to say to call the referees, to refer to the officials as the Zebras, or
I think it's okay.
A dazzle of Zebras.
I think it's okay. I think there are like six people listening to us right now, so we can say pretty much whatever we want and nobody's even going to notice.
Just no curse words. Yeah. Family friendly.
Yeah, that is the law here in Minnesota
that
for Derby announcing.
Good sense. That's very sensible of us Midwesterners.
Yeah, well, there is the odd Midwestern Derby League that has lots of swearing in their announcing and names and stuff, but we don't need to go into that at this moment.
That's not necessary, no.
It wouldn't be nice.
Yeah. And we are at the Have a Nice Day tournament.
That's such a nice day. Wait, what was the hashtag? Was it Nice Day?
Oh, yes.
Is that what it was?
Social media. It's hashtag Nice Day 2019. Wait, or is it 19?
It was 2019.
2019,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Nice Day 2019. So get on Twitter, tell us what we're doing wrong. I won't look at it until long after this bout is over.
It really won't be relevant at that time, but we're always up for some constructive criticism, compliments, concerns.
Concerns is really what I'm looking for. Watch out for the alien monster behind you.
That's
why,
a valid
thank
concern.
You.
But then, if you check it later, then
I know. Well,
then you'll already be subject to the alien apocalypse.
I'm taking my life in my hands every time I pick a microphone in my hand. I've made my peace with it.
And whenever the decision on this official review is, the Derby players will also have to make their peace with it. The official review continues as matters are discussed.
This official review has gone on for just over 3 minutes thus far. I wonder if there was a... So I do see the Detroit official review marker blinking. So there, it is their review that is under review. At this moment.
In progress.
I'm just excited that I found some piece of actual information about this official review. I learned something about it.
Well, just general information. We have 4.5 minutes left in the first period of this roller derby game. Score is Jacksonville 52 to Detroit 117. Just telling about what's going on. Really nothing incredibly pressing or new.
The whistle blows. Detroit has lost their official review, we know by looking at the scoreboard.
On the jammer line for Jacksonville is Spank and Pickle. However, it is Detroit that gets lead jammer status. That is Freakin' Reekin. That may be the first time we've seen Freakin' Reekin jam in this period, in this game so far, I believe.
Yeah, I believe it is.
Star is passed to Jacksonville jammer, or I'm sorry, Jacksonville pivot. That would be Pearl that takes the star as the jam comes to its unnatural conclusion, is called off.
So is that a 2-0 jam in favor of Detroit?
Yes, that was Freakin' Reekin on what I believe is her first jam of this game.
Right.
With the star. And we'll move to a couple jammers that we have seen already for Detroit. Number 17, Monster. And for Jacksonville, number 777, Lil Last Kicker. Last finds some daylight, and she is out as lead first.
I've noticed that Last has a purple ponytail or something, hair braid thing coming out of her helmet, so that helps identify her pretty immediately in my mind.
However, she sneaks through and is out on another scoring pass as Monster now has been able to exit the pack. Last knocks over one of her own. Collateral damage does happen at times.
That was pretty funny. That was Punny Badger. And Punny Badger took a big serious hip check as she was trying to dive out of the way of her own jammer. They seem to be fine.
I've had that lesson taught to me before. Get out of the way of your jammer.
Your jammer always has the right of way. That's an important rule in derby.
Yes. And if you get knocked on as a blocker by your jammer, it probably was your poor positioning.
I think officially it's always your fault if your jammer knocks you over.
Yeah, most likely.
119-60 is the listed score in favor of Detroit. Just about a 2-1 ratio. We've got the timeout called by Jacksonville. An official review, pardon me, called by Jacksonville. With 2 minutes and 28 seconds left in the first half. I mean, they were successful the first time, so why not do it again?
That their odds may be better for it, or you could just say it's independent.
Yeah.
So maybe their odds are no better than before, but we'll see as this official review is discussed by the folks in the center of the track. Again, if you do want to talk about anything going on in this game, including how tough the both teams are playing today, how much the announcer's voice sounds like maple syrup on a stack of hot pancakes.
Nom, nom, nom.
Any of those things, you can use hashtag NiceDay2019.
The announcing was not organized super early for this, so we did manage to get rosters for the teams, which we're very excited about. I've not seen much in terms of like sponsors or other information that we might be able to convey to you. So right now it's just all about the derby on the track. That's what we have to talk about, and whatever else comes to our mind. So we're trying to keep it professional over here.
And also keep it entertaining. We can make definitely take a second to go through the names of our officials that are helping this bout run smoothly.
Yes.
Non-skating officials are Irma Gerd, Aneurysm, Triple Destruction, Bianca Donk, Allegory, Freya Mind, Apron, and Bruce Springsteen.
Ah.
And our skating officials today, again, head skating official is No Ship Sherlock, Seer, Joss Bleeden, Ogre, Spike, Sriracha, and D.O.C. Officials are what looks to be setting themselves back into position. However, timeout still in force. Maybe I was being a little bit impatient. Just want to get this derby underway. Just about 2.5 minutes. That's all left in the first period of this game. By the way, nice math. That Detroit has twice the score of Jacksonville, just about.
Just about. One
Very
point
nice.
Short.
Quick announcer math always comes in handy.
Announcer math is some of the best math there is.
I was waiting for a palindrome myself.
Well,
I'll keep my eyes open for
we'll
that.
We'll have to watch for that for sure.
Indeed.
Haven't noticed one yet. So we have... So Jacksonville set two jammers to the line and sent one off at the last possible moment.
A little bit of sneakery, perhaps.
Yeah, I think that was meant just to confuse us. And so,
and
apparently it worked because they got lead now.
Yeah, so something with that strategy did lead them for a successful start to this jam.
So that's Plea, if I'm pronouncing that right. It's like the name Leah, but with a P on the front of it. Good times. And Plea gets through, scores those 4 points. Is that the first time we've seen her at the jam line?
I do
think.
Believe so, yes.
Well, I like this from Jacksonville.
Jacksonville's coach, I see, kind of waving that kerchief or white piece of fabric, saying,
towel?
Go, 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 do it, Jammer, I believe in you. Jammer will be calling off that jam.
So a big jam there for Jacksonville as we come into just under a minute and a half left in the first period. And Jacksonville had time during that official review to plan out exactly what they were going to do. It seems to have been successful.
And their wits may have been just a little bit, really what's going on is I smell hot dogs.
Yeah.
And it's very distracting. And the benches are over there, and I think they're able to maintain better focus because they can't quite smell those concessions cooking.
That's a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think you're correct about that. All right, we do have jammers on the track skating right now. Greco back out there for Detroit and lined up there with Sedusa, indeed.
Sedusa
was the what would you call, like, the fake jammer, the previous jam who snuck off with 2 seconds left before the jam began.
That was fun.
It was fun.
That may just have worked.
So Sedusa does have 4 points.
Not lead jammer status.
Yeah.
Gets those points.
So it looks like Greco is lead jammer. I think that's what Ogre's indicating.
That is what I see, yes. So Detroit has lead, still not calling it. but in control of this jam. No doubt looking at the period clock.
So there's the 4 points on that scoring pass for Greco of Detroit.
Nice spin by Greco on the inside line after, I think, an accidental hug from her blocker teammate.
Accidental hug from her blocker teammate is precisely how I was going to describe that, yes. An accidental hug. I mean, we all like hugs, but wasn't the time. It's like Greco headed to the box for a back block, and as soon as it was called, she shook her head yes, as if she knew that was going to be the call.
Sometimes that happens. You just accept your fate right as soon as you know that you've committed that penalty. That leaves Jacksonville with an opportunity to score some points as our lead jammer status now has been lost. And after the jam running its final conclusion.
Okay, so Jacksonville went on a little bit of a run there right at the end of that half. 127 for Detroit to 80 for Jacksonville. The lead had gotten up more toward 60 or so, maybe even more. And now it's sitting at 47 points. So 15-minute intermission, we will put down these microphones and, I don't know.
Also, please eat the hot dogs.
Yeah, float over to the hot dog smell.
Yeah, if you are hungry, enjoy the concession stand so that I don't have to be distracted by the smell of hot dogs wafting over.
I think they just have a hot dog smell machine over there. So yeah, we do have concessions. We have merch for the various teams. Lots of awesome Have a Nice Day and other T-shirts and other goods. So it looks like the track now, we've got Madison Dairyland Dolls, as well as the Minnesota Nice, their own selves, skating around on the track now. So that must be the bout coming up this evening, the second half of tonight's doubleheader.
Yeah, so don't forget to stay for the 8 p.m. game to support our home team versus a wonderful team from Madison playing, and it's sure to be a good one.
Yes, well, we will see you in about 8.5 minutes. As the second half gets underway, we start with a power jam for Jacksonville. They split the pack immediately, took the blocker penalty to spring their jammer free. And that lead jammer for Jacksonville is Lass, Lil Lass kicker, number 777. Detroit's jammer also out of the box now. Looks like that's Greco. So 4 points scored on the first pass for Jacksonville. And 4 points on the second pass, completely untouched around the outside, goes Lass. So Jacksonville starting off this half, much as they ended the first half, which is on a bit of an upswing after being down for much of this bout. Lass gets through, calls off that jam with 3 more points scored. And Jacksonville's coach out to discuss matters with our head referee, no ship Sherlock.
You gotta really be careful when you say that name.
I'm really careful when I say many. And now I guess that it's turned, the
fair
conversation
point
with the referee has now turned into an official review for Jacksonville, their third official review of the night already.
I might suspect, wait, let's see. That was Jacksonville calling the official timeout?
Yes.
Okay, my suspicion is not confirmed then. I had an idea what might the official review might be about, but
well,
I think
it's
my
good to have ideas.
Yeah.
It's nice to use your imagination.
Derby brain.
Derby brain. Use mm-hmm. your derby brain.
Yes.
The jammers having a friendly and lively conversation behind the jam line. Like to see that. Cross-team camaraderie. Those jammers, Luna Rosehip and Sedusa. Luna in black for Detroit, Sedusa in white for Jacksonville.
That is nice to see at such a tournament like this, that the teams are in this round-robin situation. They're sticking around for the weekend. You might as well make some new friends.
Absolutely. I mean, nice is in the name of the entire event.
I don't know if anyone who's not being nice would be immediately ejected and told to be more nice when they come back and after thinking about what they did that was not so nice.
We'll have to check with the head referee on that one.
They might have some opinions on that.
Right, they might. Well, their opinion on that is what counts at the very least. So we do have referees discussing the matter while coaches and captains stand at center track making conversation.
Waiting for that judgment to be handed down, as it were.
Mm-hmm. Roller Derby has never made use of a gavel for official reviews. And there's nothing to bang a gavel on, so I guess it's the right choice.
Yeah, I mean, the only other option would be one's helmet, and that's probably
not.
That
would be bad.
Yeah, that's not good for the life of the helmet.
I mean, you could put a little sort of wood pedestal thing up that was just for the purpose of the gavel, but I think it would be dangerous to have a random piece of hardwood furniture at center track.
Well, they used to have the penalty board,
that's
rather,
right,
at center track, and that's been done away with.
That's right, and I miss that penalty board because it sure is nice to be able to read the number of penalties at halftime and see who's going to foul out.
Or really just look at the board from, just draw your eye back and see which side of the board just has more ink on it.
Yeah, yeah.
And that might be telling as to how the other parts of the game, i.e. the score,
mm-hmm.
things of such nature, tend
mm-hmm.
to turn out on
a
whole.
It's true. Although, I mean, I have to say, especially standing at, or now sitting even, for heaven's sake, at track level, having no big obstructive piece of white board, because it was always a whiteboard, in my way is actually kind of nice, because I can see a little bit more now.
It does produce a much clearer field of vision where you can see the other side of the track without any major obstacles to, you know, project your x-ray vision through.
So the action will continue. The official review is over, and we will know whether it was successful or not by whether that little marker remains on Jacksonville's side. It does not. So the official review is for naught, and Jacksonville ends up 1-for-3 on official review challenges here tonight. There's a statistic for you.
Detroit looking to regain some momentum. That is Luna Rosehip that has gotten lead jammer status. Makes a quick move, cutting outside inside. Star pass was attempted by Jacksonville. Jacksonville pivot looks to rejoin the pack, but perhaps didn't do so in the correct direction of play.
So now the jammer star is just laying on the track on the back straightaway there, just right in the middle of things. I mean, could be a safety hazard if the pack ever actually went that far, which it doesn't look like they're in any hurry to do. So Jacksonville's former jammer back on the track picks that up before any dangerous things occur, so that's good.
Yeah, so the jammer star could not be recovered by the jammer until the jammer was released to the box. Jam does conclude. What a strange jam indeed.
That was a weird one, yeah. And Jacksonville with no official review to complain about, although I don't know that there wouldn't be anything really to review there. It was just an awkward circumstance. It must have been that the jammer got called to the box before she handed it over, and so she remains the jammer, so the pivot can't put it on. So she dropped it per instructions, but then she got sent to the box because she was skating out of the pack, probably.
Yeah, that would be the call, I'd suspect. I don't know necessarily all the referee signals.
No.
But no, the major ones. Jamming for Jacksonville. We see Spank and Pickle, number 6116. For Detroit, that would be Monster in control of the clock for this jam as the lead jammer at the moment. You never know, again, how things may change over the course of even one single jam.
'Tis true. Monster does get through for 4 points on that pass.
Star is passed for Jacksonville. It looks like Pearl now becomes pivot to jammer. Pearl makes scoring pass of her own. Monster still in control as the lead jammer. Monster breaks through the front of the pack. Now exiting on another scoring pass with Pearl not far behind.
So both jammers scoring, which suits the leader on the scoreboard, being Detroit. They're perfectly happy at this point to continue scoring. And if Jacksonville happens to score too, oh well.
Jacksonville had been gaining some very nice momentum. However, on this last pass, it was Detroit that got out and is back on another scoring pass, while Pearl, as the pivot turn jammer, remains in the pack at this time.
Woo. The jam is over. That was a long one.
That looked exhausting, absolutely.
I wouldn't say it's exactly hot in here, but it's warm.
Yeah,
it's like, I mean, it's almost 90 degrees outside, right?
Yeah, you can only do so much with a building this size to keep the atmosphere cool. And again, these skaters are exerting themselves, let's say, quite a bit.
Absolutely. We've got Freakin' Reakin back to the line for Detroit, a name I remember, or recognize, rather, from my many years of announcing Detroit, announcing roller derby in the state of Michigan, where I was before I came back here. We do have a lead jammer here for Jacksonville. Yet again, that is Lass.
Freakin' Rican just had a couple to beat before she is out as well. However, Jacksonville does make the decision to call off the jam. It does appear that so far in the first few jams of this period, Jacksonville has been able to gain some momentum. So they are looking to close that score gap. Right now, they have passed the century mark. They have 105 points to Jacksonville's 167.
That's Detroit's 167.
Oh, goodness.
That's okay.
My apologies.
That's all right. It's getting to the time of the boat where the announcers start to zone out because our brains are like, I haven't done this for a while. I'm getting tired now.
That happens to you too?
It had just happened the last time I was talking, to be honest. We do have a lead jammer here for Detroit. That should be Nat Attack, if my memory serves.
Makes another scoring pass untouched.
Well, it looks like Jacksonville down a couple of blockers right now. And their blockers that they did have were helping try to play offense. Now Nat runs into some resistance there. From Lucinda Nickers.
Star is passed for Jacksonville. And that was number 141, Plea, that we had seen make a really successful jam at the start of this period. Pivot turn jammers are always my favorite. Like, usually you're a pivot, and you have the stripe, and you have that purpose, and you just want your destiny to be fulfilled.
Sometimes destinies change. Looks like we've got a high block now on Plea of Jacksonville. So that's going to be a power jam. Tell me.
Yeah, destinies, in fact, do change. Detroit's jammer, Nat Attack, being sent to the box. Therefore, Plea is now released for what remains in this jam.
Only about 12 seconds left on the jam clock, so both jammers back on the track, just enough to take a big hit.
Huge hit by Driver.
Yeah. And that was enough to let Nat Attack get through in the final second. So 3 points scored on that last pass for Jacksonville. And so here we are.
Some number of points by Detroit.
Some number for Detroit.
So in that last jam, Detroit did get the better of the situation with 19 points. However, Jacksonville still holds strong. 7 points gained in that last jam. 74 points divide these two teams.
Yeah.
Still within striking range.
Announcer math is my favorite math. This is an official timeout. So officially, the officials are taking some time out of the game.
For official business.
For official business, thank you. I didn't know where I was going to end up with that, so you really put a button on it for me. I appreciate it.
I got you. A button and a bow, all for you.
That's right. Mm-hmm. We're such a good team, show.
We are. It's true. I'm looking forward to even the next game that's happening at 8 p.m.
Yeah. Tell us about that.
Yeah, that'll be our home team, the Minnesota Nice, versus the Dairyland Dolls B team from Madison, Wisconsin.
Those are two leagues that have an extremely long relationship.
Definitely. Both members of the North Central Division.
Yep. Old school.
Very much so.
Yeah.
Both original leagues in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
That's right. And these are the B teams, not the chartered WFTDA squads. But nonetheless, that history remains, and everybody's aware of it, even if you haven't been a part of it yourself.
The history does remain intact, and these two teams will be forging a piece of their collective history here in Minnesota. We have, let's see, I believe the charter team has a game coming up later in the summer against Jacksonville. Jacksonville B team gaining some momentum, not lead, but out of the pack first.
Seduce
double
a nice
spin.
Yeah, she had that nice spin, but around the three wall. But then Detroit had the one extra blocker hovering to slow her down, which was a really nice move. So Greco is the lead jammer, even though Sedusa was the jammer that got out first and has already scored points. And Detroit content to run out the clock, and indeed, the Detroit blockers do hold up Sedusa, allowing Greco to come around and possibly outscore her opponent. There is a two-blocker advantage for Detroit in this jam at the current time.
Greco swings around one blocker and a second blocker. And on that earlier in that pass, Detroit, they kind of had this 1-2 defense. It was really nice. Jammers swung around one blocker, and then another blocker was ready to hit them out. Both jammers now entering the pack or approaching the pack on a scoring pass. That would be Detroit that has lead, so in control of the clock for the remainder of this jam.
Greco manages to keep her feet on the inside line. With 30 seconds left on the jam clock, Detroit content to run this one out. But, I mean, there's a lot of derby left to be skated, almost 20 minutes left.
That is quite a lot of derby. Anything can happen. Greco knows this, and maybe taking advantage to draw out this jam, having control as the lead jammer. Incredible defense by both teams, keeping their tripods intact, holding those jammers as the jam concludes. We do have an announcement. There's a red Mazda Miata with your lights on. So if that sounds like it may be your car, please do be sure to attend to it, a red Mazda Miata. And you will have additional time that won't disrupt your derby viewing as we have a timeout called. So again, if you own that car, look into that. Otherwise, you might be finding a friend to jump it later, and that would be an inconvenience.
I mean, I guess it could be a rental, I suppose.
I suppose. Yes, if you own or rent that car, red Mazda Miata, we do encourage you to check into that.
If you've stolen that car, please return it to its rightful owner.
And then promptly report yourself to the authorities.
Well, it's just not nice to steal cars.
It's the nice thing to do, not to steal cars. In fact, if you have stolen a car, what are you even doing it? Having a nice day. it's incongruent.
It is. Well, there's got to be some surprise at a tournament like this. And if the surprise is that a ring of car thieves has infiltrated one of these roller derby teams, then I should like to see the documentary about that in 3 to 5 years.
That'll be the reason I reinstate my Netflix account.
Fantastic. Looks like Lass to the line for Jax. And Luna Rosehip out there for Detroit. It's going to be Lass for Jacksonville, lead jammer. 201 to 128, the listed score.
Jammer's using fancy footwork. Skating backwards, skating forwards, towing the line. Some excellent work on that scoring pass. Our Jacksonville jammer is the first to emerge. Little last kicker. Again, Jacksonville in a point deficit, looking to regain that momentum.
Well, the way Lass bounced off that hip of Detroit blocker Slamazon and then was forced to call off that jam was a real thing of beauty. She just hit the hip, spun all the way around, saw where she was, knew she'd have to recycle, and called it off quick before her opponent could score.
Jammers must be attentive and have
agile.
Sights. Yes.
And anonymous. No, I'm just trying to think of more A words. I'm already out. Pathetic. I'm not worth the money they're paying me to announce this bout.
Aesthetic skaters.
Yes, aesthetic is a very good one.
I mean, they don't have to be. They just generally are.
Yeah. Sedusa and Freakin' Reekin, the jammers of record. It's going to be Reekin for Detroit, your lead jammer.
freaking Rican on a scoring pass. At the encouragement of her bench, calls off the jam, gaining those 4 points, leaving Jacksonville with 0 points on that jam.
See, that's why you should always just, instead of thinking about things when you have a microphone, you should just say them immediately. All of them, all the time. That's Nat Attack to the line for Detroit. Lined up there with, I believe that's Buckeye Brawler for Jacksonville. First time I've called that name as a jammer. And it works out for Jacksonville. Another new jammer, another lead jam call.
16 minutes left in the game. Jacksonville decides to call off the jam, earning 1 point on that jam for their trouble as being in control as the lead jammer.
And that one ended the same way as the previous jam that Jacksonville had lead, which was that the hip of Slamazon bounced a jammer out of bounds who then immediately called off the jam.
The hip of Slamazon is it's like an obstacle in a labyrinth.
Yeah.
Like you must answer the question of, you know, the Sphinx, the riddle of the Sphinx, and you must pass the hip of the Slamazon.
That's right. It sounds like an excellent MacGuffin in an episode of a cartoon. Superhero cartoon show.
Yes. Wee bit of a pileup. Both jammers still on their initial pass. I see Greco for Detroit wearing the jammer star, but that would be gaining lead jammer status of Jacksonville. Little last kicker.
A big power move to get lead and get free of the pack. And this time a nice leisurely apex jump to get those 4 points. She had a smile on her face.
Leisurely, but well-timed.
It was well-timed. See, the trick is to make it look easy, which is what she did.
That is what roller derby training will do. It will just make it look effortless. Quick recoveries, even when they fall. Another part of training.
My sense is that her smile just keeps getting bigger as she goes around and does this. Her team is cheering her on, and her coaches are waving those white towel things. But maybe it's just Lass's mouth guard I'm seeing, but it seems like she's got a big, wide smile going most of this jam.
Sometimes it could be a mouth guard. I think in this case it must be genuine joy because she has completed yet another scoring pass, earning 12 points. Greco still scoreless on this jam, or I'm sorry, Detroit still scoreless on this jam. Looks like the star has been passed for Detroit. Lil Lass makes another run at a scoring pass. Detroit's star has been passed to number 31, Ryder. I believe that may be the first time we have seen Ryder with the jammer star on.
Agreed. Lil Lass kicker does get through for yet another 4 points as the jam clock dwindles. And Lass is awarded one last point on that final jam as her coach helpfully counted out the final seconds so that she knew how much time she had. So she knew she had to hit the pack, and it was just one shot. There was no circling back around. Did manage to get the 1 point. Huge jam there for Jacksonville.
21-point jam, looks like. That may be the highest scoring jam in this game. I'm not keeping...
Yeah, we're not keeping those statistics.
Yeah, we're not. That would require more pens and more paper.
Yeah, probably a writing surface would actually be helpful.
Yeah, but to the best of my memory, as it serves, that may be the highest scoring jam in this game, or at least one of the very highest.
Certainly close to the top, if not the highest. So excellent job there by Jacksonville. The timeout by Detroit, looking to nip that kind of momentum in the bud, as they say, 213 to 154 is the listed score with 13 minutes and 19 seconds left in this second period.
Jacksonville with a rallying cry.
That rallying cry, Duval, which is the county that Jacksonville is in the state of Florida.
That makes more sense to me now that I've heard Duval and seen Duval.
I've heard them saying that for many, many years, having first announced Jacksonville way back in 2008. when I was with the Bradentucky Bombers, of all things.
Jacksonville, I saw their coach jump up for joy as Jammer called lead. That is number 330, starting with the Jammer star this jam. That is Buckeye Brawler. I thought Buckeyes were an Ohio thing.
Well, a lot of people are transplants. I mean, that's just how it is.
Fair enough.
So 4 points for Jacksonville. And they have... Go ahead.
Luna Rose Hip, not far behind that Jammer.
That's all right. So both Jammers hit the pack, forced to recycle. And both packs running the pack back as far as they can. An inside recycle and an outside recycle. Luna breaks to the outside, then back to the inside. But the three wall of white jerseys up front reforms very quickly. As Buckeye, facing an extremely strong wall of black jerseys in the back as well, finally calls it off at the behest of her coach.
I was just thinking that it seemed to me to be a long jam, and Jacksonville may have felt that way as well, perhaps. I mean, I didn't mean to send that message out onto the track, but Jacksonville did make the decision to conclude that jam by calling it.
Well, if the Jacksonville coach can read your feelings about a jam, Shug, then the two of you should join the circus.
Or at least have some sort of act together. We could
certainly, yeah.
Yeah. Circus or, I don't know, write a TV show.
Something,
screenplay.
Yeah.
Yeah, something cool.
Something cool, like
yeah.
The circus.
Speaking
Monster
of cool.
is the jammer for Detroit, and the jammer is Sedusa for Jacksonville. A lot of whistles blew. Looks like Monster, both jammers sent to the box for track cuts.
Wild.
That's the second time we've had a double jammer penalty.
But this time they pretty much sat almost at the same moment, so they rejoined play nearly at the same time.
So the real function of that is to make this a two-minute jam. So depending on who gets the advantage here, I mean, the pressure is really on Jacksonville to make use of those 2 minutes and score a lot more points than their opponent. Generally, we know the tie goes to the leader, and Detroit with that 60-point lead, looking to take advantage here and run out some serious clock in this one. Monster does get out of the pack first, though she sure had to earn her way through the pack.
I just want to call out this Jacksonville blocker who's been staying at the top of the pack, holding it down, number 614, Harshmallow, really made it difficult for Monster to exit the pack and is doing that again. Backwards blocking at the top of the pack, trying to hang on to that jammer and not letting her go. Monster uses her toe stops, finally gets around. Jacksonville jammer in the box. Detroit currently on a power jam.
So that was a star pass prior to that jammer going to the box, because that is not the same jammer the last time I was paying attention to a Jacksonville jammer. And the jam is over.
Reaching its natural conclusion after those 2 minutes following both jammers going to the box nearly simultaneously.
So that time all three jammers went to the box in the same jam. You don't often get to say that. Good times.
Oh, yeah.
One of those weird stats.
Yeah. Three different jammers in the box. One jam, three jammers, multiple penalties. Next jamming is Freakin' Reekin' for Detroit. And that's number 777, Lil Last Kicker for Jacksonville.
I would say Last has been the most frequent jammer for Jacksonville here today. As she comes in from the outside, immediately makes a jammer-on-jammer hit, but is nonetheless stuck at the back of the pack. Look at a high block there on Detroit's Slamazon.
So she will sit those dangerous hips in the penalty box. Detroit down their jammer, so we are on a power jam, also down one blocker. Jacksonville setting up to try to get their jammer through on this pass. Detroit hoping to burn some time from that penalty.
Great job by the two Detroit blockers up front, slowing Lass down. She does get through and get those 4 points.
Also calling out Lass, too. Great job with awareness, noting that she was able to come in only behind one of the blockers instead of having to come in behind both of them. Nice little hop on the outside to get around.
That one skate, leaning balance, spin, stay on your feet, that's a great way to earn 4 points.
Mm-hmm. Nothing like a very cool move to seal the deal and get your points.
Lass being forced out again and again and again, trying to keep her feet on the track. Sometimes she's successful, sometimes less so. That time she hit the track and was took a second to get her bearings before getting up. This freaking Rican back on the track, taking hit after hit from the Jacksonville blockers now.
And a big hit just now. Lots of hits getting knocked out, re-entering, but then sometimes a bigger hit. All of these blockers not letting up. Very hoppy jammers for the most part. And those blockers following, knocking them out, recovering, pulling them back, using all the tools in their toolbox to try to shut those jammers down.
That's right. And they've been successful quite a few times. There's been very little easy jamming here tonight. There have been some high-scoring jams, but often that was because they've chosen to run out the jam rather than taking their 4 points and calling it off.
Very seldom do we see a jammer just slide through untouched.
That's Nat Attack jamming for Detroit up front and gets lead as Buckeye Brawler at the back of the pack for Jacksonville, still on her initial pass. No pack, and so the pivot for Jacksonville going to head to the box as Nat Attack is sprung free by the rules of roller derby.
As you can only go so far out from the pack to engage with the jammer, penalty is called on Detroit blocker. Buckeye Brawler makes a move on the inside. Detroit trying to set up something anew. Buckeye Brawler holding the star. Penalties being called. Number 1-4 for Detroit heading to the box. Jacksonville has one blocker in the box. Detroit has two at the moment. Nat Attack still in control as the lead jammer. We only have just under 5 minutes left in this roller derby game.
So Detroit has been hovering mostly around about a 60-point lead. They've pushed that up a little bit higher to 76 on the scoreboard at this moment. Familiar faces wearing the stars, Greco and
Sedusa.
Sedusa.
Both skaters we've seen jamming many times so far. It is Sedusa that is the lead jammer, Jacksonville, hoping to gain some advantage, some momentum, make up that score deficit. Greco is out of the pack after Jacksonville blockers have to let her go. That would be Jacksonville jammer heading to the box. It will run, this jam will run the full 2 minutes and lead status has been lost. Greco now has the opportunity to lengthen that lead of Detroit's. Jacksonville blockers being very strategic about when and where they re-enter so that they can allow their players to extend the distance that they can continue to block that jammer.
Greco hit the track pretty hard that time, but managed to get through. Ends up just stepping over her opponent's and blocker's skate to get through. And now Sedusa back on the track, a little bit rested from her 30-second break. So she easily passes by Greco, but then knocked to the outside of the track, forced to recycle.
One more to pass. Lucinda Nickers does not quite get Greco out, but Greco makes it out.
A long 2 minutes.
That was a long 2 minutes indeed. Detroit was more successful putting more points on the board for that jam. Mm-hmm. And Detroit will choose to field number 667, Luna Rosehip, who's been successful during this game. And Jacksonville jammer V Furious, also successful in prior jams. I think it's been a while since we've seen V Furious don the star at the beginning of the jam.
Agreed. V Furious stuck at the back of the pack. Luna out front, lead jammer for Detroit.
Luna Rosehip really using that burst of speed to get through that scoring pass. V Furious not quite passing that bunch of Detroit blockers.
So the jam clock with more time on it than the period clock means this could be the last jam of this bout if it's not called off. And it won't be called off because we've had a track cut on the former lead jammer, Luna. So that means this is going to be the last jam of the bout, right?
Yeah, indeed.
Maybe if there was like another stoppage of play for some reason.
Right, but if the jam reaches its natural conclusion, this will be the final jam. So V Furious as the jammer, wanting to put what points on the board she can, especially before Detroit jammer re-enters play.
That time the pack really lightened up. Looks like 3-on-1 for a moment there in the pack. So advantage jammers when the pack is so light. Now the pack has reestablished itself. And bodies are hitting the polished concrete all over the place.
Big hits. Looks like both of these jammers have two passes each for 4 points on those passes. Luna Rosehip gets back in and does not score any additional points on that pass.
We did have Luna called to the penalty box as that jam concluded, but as that jam concluded the period clock, we think this is going to be the end of this one. The unofficial score, 268 to 188 in favor of the Detroit Roller Derby All-Stars B Team.
In this bout, besting the Jacksonville River City Rat Pack, both of these teams played an incredible game and are getting high fives from the next squads to play the 8 p.m. game. So if you do want to give these teams some high fives, make sure to let them know they played a fantastic game today.
Excellent. Jacksonville doing the little bridge move, which I understand to be kind of a sign of honor and respect for your opponent.
Yeah, which I originated with the London Roller Derby team, have heard.
That may well be, yes, that may well be.
Being that they have that London Bridge and whatnot.
Right. Do they? I thought that moved to Arizona. Well, maybe that was something else.
I thought there was that song about it falling down.
I don't know. If it fell down, why are they doing it? Whatever. Who knows?
No one knows.
Anyway, Detroit wins. We got Minnesota versus Madison coming up next. We will see you all soon right back here at the Doug Woog Arena in South St. Paul, Minnesota.